Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you the Loupe tool in preview. So in preview, there are many different ways to magnify an image that you're looking at. I'm going to double click on an image here and it's going to open up in preview. And I'm going to use the magnification buttons here at the top to zoom in. And I can now scroll up and down and move around to see what's in the image. Also, for viewing, I can go to Tools, Show Magnifier, and I get this circle here that now I can move around and magnify any part of the image that I want. But both of these tools are just for you viewing the image. They don't create any kind of permanent change to the image. They're just kind of a temporary viewing thing. There's another tool that will actually allow you to annotate the image with zoomed in portions. This is called the Loupe tool. And it's part of annotation. So go to the Tools for Markup right here, turn that on, and then you see all the markup tools here, including bits of text and shapes and different things that you can add to the image. Under Shapes, there's this loop icon here. Hard to tell what that is, but once you use it, you can see that the circle loop appears. It's not following the cursor, but it is magnifying this section. I can click and drag it anywhere I want to magnify an area. And then I can adjust the size of the loop by dragging this blue dot here. And I can adjust the magnification by dragging this green dot along the edge. So now I've magnified this section of the image. One interesting thing is that you can add multiple loop annotations. So I'm going to go and do it again. And I get a second loop. And now I can use this to magnify something else on the image. And you can have these two actually move and overlap each other. It will actually even double magnify the things under the loop. If you control click, you can change the position. So I can send this loop behind the other loop or in front of the other loop. I can also delete a loop. If I've got it selected, that means I've got the blue and the green dots there where I don't have them here, I can actually hit the delete key and it will remove that. Now it's important to realize these are real annotations. Just like if you add a piece of text or a shape or an arrow or something on the image. So if I go and export this or just simply save it, I will get an image that has those embedded in it. So now I look at this one here and you can see these aren't loops anymore, not annotation ones anyway. These are permanent parts of the image. And I can actually view this image in anything. I can send it in an email, whatever I want. It's going to look like this. Whereas here, these are actually still loops that can be moved and manipulated and changed and deleted. Now this not only works on images in preview, but you can do it on PDFs as well. So here's my PDF of keyboard shortcuts. I can go and do the same thing here, turn on these annotation tools, add a loop, and you can see here it magnifies what's underneath there. So if there's something in this document I wanted to point out, I can do it and magnify it as I want. And the great thing, of course, is a PDF is vector-based, so as you magnify it's still going to be pretty smooth underneath there. So you can add these to PDFs to help you point out things in documents if you're collaborating with somebody. Likewise, you can do it with images as well, or just use them to make your images more interesting before you post them on social media or send them to friends.